30 seconds.
They know that the conditions can and probably will change here throughout the course of this 60-60. It's pretty quick, though. Two 14-lappers with a half-time break. So essentially, it's two legs. Get through the first bit cleanly, maintain or increase your position, and then bring it home strong. 100 points waiting for the winner.
Green flag, formation lap commencing.
As the field leaves the line, let's check out the Fuso starting grid and the best qualifying time we've ever seen here. Mark Winterbottom, a 1 minute 30.6. The old record was a 32 even way back in 2000. Craig Lowndes, and that man will start alongside him. Then season best for both Tander and for Davis, and great performance. Chaz Mostert and Fabian Coulthard, fifth and sixth. Shane Van Gisbergen, VIP Pet Foods, in seventh from Jason Bright, position eight, Team BOC. Then David Reynolds in the Bottle-O Ford, position nine, and Will Davison, we just spoke to him on the grid, in 10th.
It's been an extraordinary run for David Reynolds in particular in terms of top 10 crompo. As we take a look at Jamie Wincup there in 13th, second in the championship. He's got David Wall next to him. David Reynolds has had 16 straight top 10 qualifiers. He hasn't been outside the top 10 since he broke through for pole at Darwin, so it's been quite a run. As we continue through the field, Alex Premer and Rick Kelly in the Nissan Altima. The Nissan Altima, by the way, also hitting the Australian market next week, so in the coming weeks they'll be able to drive it on the track and home from the track. Russell Ingall, Super Cheap Auto Racing, in his last ever weekend here at this iconic circuit. James Moffat in 27th, and Mauro Engel, who's been over to Macau in the break, the GT Series, and claimed a lap record there and also pole position. He's actually had success at this circuit, Mauro, when he drove here for Erebus Motorsport last year. But he will start from the rear of the grid. So it's all about the top four in terms of the championship, and Jamie Wincup has it stacked against him out of those four, starting from position 13. And our V8 Supercar audience, well, you know your stuff because you know how hard it is to win from mid-pack. And not only that, the three guys who he's fighting for the title are all ahead of him. Two of them are on the front row. And if you wanted to stack the Ford's side against the Holden side, let's remember that Alex Davison and Chaz Mostert are up there ahead of him as well. So David Reynolds as well, Will Davison. He's got a few, Mark Winterbottom I'm talking about, he's got a few decoy runners in between him and Jamie Wincup.
He has. There are lots of subplots in this story. There's Rick Kelly, Jack Daniels, and Nissan Altima. Just getting some warmth into those tyres. Incidentally, Jason Bright this weekend, 200th V8 Supercar event start. Congratulations to Brighty. It's been a great innings. Joins the big names up there with the big numbers against their name. It's a nice dry track and the fringes look pretty reasonable at the moment, Mark. The track's been bathed in sunshine for the last 45 minutes or so.
Yeah, it's taken that little bit of condition out, which we had some variable conditions earlier and some drama attached to that. Dave Reynolds, another good job, as Matt just referred to. Very hard to start the cars here, Crompo, and that's the risk for Wincup. When you're in P13, you've got to make a good start and you've got to get to the right-hand side of the road to take the drama out of turn one.
Join us on Twitter. Use the hashtag V8SC or at V8 Supercars. Let us know your thoughts throughout the day.
Look for action at turn two. There's often plenty of it. And turn four, the hairpin on lap one.
Green flag.
So race 32. Second last event of the season. The Sergeant Security Phillip Island 360. And a critical moment in the championship. And an even start as Will Davison slots out from 10th and goes in search of some room on the left-hand side of the circuit. But Lowndes and Winterbottom drag it down to turn one.
Right, Lowndes might have got him.
Right, got a bad start.
Lowndes did get him. So the championship leader goes through the southern loop first. There's Reynolds stuck on the outside of Will Davison. A bit of bump and grind behind him.
Wincup, good start too, Matt.
Oh, ugly. Just holding on.
Ugly.
Yeah, Wincup made profit from Bright's bad start.
Down here at turn four. So everybody's treading warily on this first lap. It's been raining quite hard, so once you go off the black stuff, the green stuff is super slippery. Shane Van Gisbergen, good pacing qualifying inside the top 10.
Graphically demonstrates the curb profile there. Lowndes was very wide over the top of the hill, so it's much flatter in that location than it was in the right-hander we call Hayshed at Turn 8.
Gartander's making a move early too, and now he's putting pressure on Mark Winterbottom. And there's Wincup, dicing with David Reynolds. And you're on board with the bottle of Ford as Wincup gets past him. So Jamie Wincup's already gone up a couple of spots. At the completion of lap one, it's Lowndes leading Winterbottom. Wincup up to ninth. Four spots in one lap.
Davey had a bit of run at him then. He actually came off the last corner a bit stronger.
Tandem by. This is a big story because Winterbottom's start wasn't good enough. And for Garth Tander to get by, this will have a big impact on Mark Winterbottom's performance. Now, there may be tyre pressure. This is a very, very hard place. And it's probably the hardest place in Australia on tyres. So he may have chosen to start with them lower. If he's done that, that may explain some of the difference in the pace between Lowndes, Tander and Winterbottom now back in third.
Gisbergen having a look up the inside of Fabian Coulthard. They started sixth and seventh on the grid, so they're still locked in combat. Nice little buffer for Lowndes now, 1.5 seconds.
And that's what he's after. He's after the ability to control his own destiny, and right now he can do that. Got himself onto the front row of the grid, got a good start, got away from Winterbottom, and now has Garth Tander in between him and car number five. Tander's had victory here before. He's had four wins here, including back-to-backs in the 500s in 2008 and 2009.
Matt, Tim Edwards just confirmed exactly what you guys were speculating. Mark Winterbottom has started with lower tyre pressures, so they will come up to pressure as the race goes on.
Wincup up to ninth from 13th, so it's been a good march forward here, but he's not out of the woods because this is another good run from David Reynolds off the final corner. If he gets a strong enough run, he'll have a look down the inside here. But despite the low pressure area behind Jamie's car, Jamie's actually inching away in the middle of the straight there. How's the twitch? How's the twitch? So both of them, in fact, Wincup and David, both had a bit of a moment down at turn one then. That was pretty significant.
Well, one happened early and one happened mid. So he turned it in. This is the start, so it's a pretty even jump. Very good secondary part of the start for Lowndes. Less wheel spin as they went out of shot. It was a very good start there. That was also Wincup who was able to avoid. This is Lowndes on board, so you can just hear that nice traction. Secondary part of the start was better than Mark Winterbottom.
And Wincup went down the inside of everybody. That was where he gained some advantage. And there was a bit of push and shove back here between turns two and three as well. Scott Pye getting crossed up on the grass.
So 1.6 seconds now for Craig Lowndes over Tander. Reynolds just seems to have settled into a groove, or perhaps Wincup settled into a better groove, although Reynolds comes back at him again. So wherever Jamie Wincup goes at the moment, David Reynolds is waiting to have a go at him. Chaz Mostert in fifth. That's Alex Davison ahead of him in fourth. So we've got Lowndes, Tander, Winterbottom, the top three at the moment.
Normally when you picked up the ripple strip on the inside of the final corner there, it upset
just
the car.
Keep the pressure on it. Think about your bars.
Upset the car so much that you wouldn't use that extra little 500 or 600 mil, but they're getting away with it now with this change to the circuit year on year. That Vallelunga curbing on the outside though of turn one does still rattle the fillings out of your teeth, and you can see that on the exit and the onboard there.
Boys, it took only three laps for the lap record to fall. New lap record is now 1:33.21, eclipsing Craig Lowndes, eclipsing his own time set last year at 1:33.27.
It's interesting that Mostert goes back into second gear then. It was a big rev on the downshift. Problem here for Fiori. Looks like he's had trouble down at turn four at the hairpin in the right-hander. He's recovering from that, or Has he recovered? It's still ongoing.
This is still on board with Chaz. There was a lot of movement from Alex Davison. You see the body language of the car, a couple of spots that he had to run wide. Hasn't quite got it back online from those new curbs. And that's down the inside. Well done, Dave Reynolds. This is a very important thing. I was about to say before, this is factory Ford versus factory Holden. And Dave Reynolds now being able to get by Jamie Whincup is significant.
You've got Holdsworth in here as well in the Erebus Motorsport V8 entry. So he's right in behind running champion at the moment. There is the Urban Tools entry, and there's James Moffat. Remember, he had a moment, and he's got a problem with the right rear there. He's got a puncture. Big moment in qualifying for him, so he qualified down the back. And that's obviously going to bring that car into pit lane. He's got to slow it down so he doesn't do too much guard damage or he'll spend too long stationary as they repair it. There's all the grass on the road from whatever happened to Dean Fiore early on. He's grabbed one of the coat's higher braking markers down there.
Oh, that's going to be bad. That's Courtney and Bright. That was always going to happen. There was always going to be contact, and the curve on the inside, because it's effectively lower compared to the surface of the road, you can get in and use more of it. So James thought, no problem, I'll just drive the car in over that. And contact, obviously, between Jason Bright and James Courtney.
So it hasn't started well at all for Jason Bright. He qualified in eighth spot, dropped a few at the start. This will be the move that David Reynolds puts last turn on Jamie Whincup, who's wise enough to give him the room. Remember, David Reynolds coulda, shoulda won his first ever race here last year. They had a problem in pit lane. It was the one that got away. He ended up having to wait until the Gold Coast a few weeks ago to get his career breakthrough win. Now he comes back with confidence and he's attacking Jamie Whincup and doing it well. So Reynolds in ninth. This is under investigation.
I think he might be up far enough, actually. I think he's up past the B pillar or into the peripheral vision of the driver in front. I think he may have just got away with that one when they review that. So Lowndes now betters his own lap record with a 32.82 on the previous lap. Remember, he held the previous lap record for so many years, way back in Bridgestone tyre days. So Tander is now under pressure from Winterbottom. Winterbottom's got better.
See Jason Wright pick the throttle up there. Oh, problem here for Scott McLaughlin, front right. Very quick in practice four this morning, particularly in those mixed conditions.
I think I popped the right front.
Yep, certainly is a right front, Scotty. It's gone. So we've seen James Moffat already have to come into pit lane. And now Scott McLaughlin will follow him with tyre troubles, but no troubles for Craig Lowndes, who continues to push ahead at the front.
Scott McLaughlin limping back, and they have had a test in this car, trying to get on top of that weird electrical drama they had at the Gold Coast for he and Jack Perkins. They didn't find it again. They couldn't replicate it. And now he's got a problem. They'll have to pit him. Remember, too, in the 60-60 Super Sprint format, if you are a lap down at the end of the first half, you get the lap back for the start of the second half. That's something just to bear in mind for anyone that has a drama like James Moffat, who is 28th last and a lap down. This is the fight for second. Tander and Winterbottom, the official factory Holden Racing Team Commodore versus the official factory Pepsi Max Crew FDR Ford. Lowndes leading 1.7 seconds down the road. Next in the shots, Alex Davison, Mostert, Coulthard, Van Gisbergen, Will Davison, Reynolds, Whincup, Holdsworth is sticking with them in the U and Erebus Mercedes-Benz. In the background, that was Tim Blanchard putting the move on James Courtney for position 12. So we're halfway into the first half, if that makes sense. Seven down as they run through area known as the Hay Shed in the over the top of Lukey Heights, named after Len Lukey, who ran and owned this circuit for many, many years. Post-race investigation, in fact, will be held for the James Courtney and Jason Bright contact earlier on, as McLaughlin now pits in the Fujitsu Commodore. First time for him in the championship here at Phillip Islands. Never raced a V8 supercar here because the Dunlop Series does not race here and hasn't for quite some years. Has raced a state-based Formula Ford here, but it's not going his way at the moment. He's down the back. Lowndes still leading. And this is the fight of the moment, though. Tanner versus Winterbottom, lap 8 of the island.
Welcome back. This is Alex Davison. Under pressure from Chaz Mostert, the youngster's going to have a look on the inside at the exit of the Southern Loop. The two Fords are rubbing. Davison will go onto the side. He just manages to stay onto the track. 220 k's an hour down here through Stoner Corner. Turn three, hard on the brakes at turn four, the hairpin. What a battle between Alex Davison and Chaz Mostert.
And Chaz was making sure that Alex had to do it the long, hard way. And in the end, he's come off second best here because it's allowed Fabian to buy in. So Alex did a good job of staying cool under pressure, went round the outside, was pretty slippery out there offline as well.
Whoa, oh, there goes Chaz!
That is wild.
You can count his blessings after that one.
Just gather it up, have a drink.
Lucky that sand trap's there, that was put in many years ago, but honestly, that was going to be a huge accident when he made the grass. We've seen some very... Oh, no, Davison around. Contact there. That's bad for championship and his consistency at this point of the year.
So big damage in the right rear corner of David Reynolds' car with another flat now. Is that as a result of contact? James Small, engineer in at Ford Performance Racing. Tim Edwards, Grant McPherson. So what's beneath all that?
And this is the time when they needed cool heads. They needed cool heads to prevail because remember we're getting to lap 14 out of 28. This is where we have a half-time break. So they're only five laps away from having that break. And Reynolds was having such a great run. So that right rear's gone.
Can see where the tyres whipped around and smashed the car, but I can't tell really whether or not another car's had a rub on there.
I think Van Gisbergen was involved with the Davison one, wasn't he? So
Will joins the field at the rear of it. Wow. Craig Lowndes has a 2-second lead over Garth Tander. Be the happiest man on the circuit at the moment to know that all this is going on way behind him and he's in the clear. David Reynolds again into pit lane.
And I think Wincup and Van Gisbergen were in the middle of a battle, and I've got a feeling that Jamie may have unseated Van Gis. The safety car is going to go out here as well, so this is going to change everything. This will be because of the junk on the road. There it is. So the Petters STP safety car's gone out. And this will condense the field. So Lowndes, 2.1 second margin, it vanishes. So what happens here? Gizzy and Chaz Mostert make contact. How Mostert got away with this one. It rooster tails out of the gravel, did its job beautifully, and he got back on here. Here's the onboard. Let's listen. Skates out of the grass. He's grabbed a couple of gears on the way. Watch this one.
That there, he'll be in stride for.
And look who was on the inside of that too.
Yeah, I mentioned before it was Wincup, but I don't think Jamie actually triggered it. My first impression was he might have, but I think he actually got a shove from Shane there.
Guys, I'm just with Tim Edwards now. Tim, you've lodged an email over that incident?
Yeah, well, Gizzy's a moron, isn't he? I mean, he's not in the hunt here. He's just driving like an idiot. First of all, he takes Chaz out, and three corners later, he takes Will out.
Right, we'll see what comes back. Thanks, mate.
Yeah, and my point about Wincup on the inside there was that he could well have been an innocent victim as well in that.
He was close, wasn't he? Absolutely.
Could have crueled him. So just minutes after I was saying that Lowndes is the happiest bloke on the circuit, he'll still be happy that he's leading, but not so happy that he's 2.5 second lead.
We're at both hands, we're struggling a bit. Winterbottom is using his usual slow start, strong finish.
Yeah, that 2 second lead's now evaporated because of the Petters STP safety car as Jeremy Moore just runs him through a few strategy plays. So let's watch this. Shane Van Gisbergen nudging, pushing. Wing Cup dives through on the left-hand side and escapes the scene.
The thing is, he is a fair way up the inside, so they're all going to get into a big brawl about this, but he may have got down the inside because of the initial tapping.
Out on the safety car, no more lateral weaving or longitudinal weaving. Maintaining speed, you can maintain 5 car lengths in front. Wait for my call.
The net result, as Mark Dutton runs through Jamie Wincup, is that Wincup has now moved up to sixth. Remember, we asked you, can he win this race from position 13? Well, the numbers were stacking against him. You can have your say on our V8 viewer vote. What about now? Can he win it from position number 6? They've got to get to the halfway mark of lap 14. They'll have a break. And then they'll let loose again.
Green.
Investigation will be held post-race for Shane Van Gisbergen on Will Davison. Now, Craig Lowndes, Garth Tander, Mark Winterbottom. That's your top three. Jeremy Moore said to Lowndes that Winterbottom was doing his usual. Start slow, finish strong, so be aware of him.
Tander's got a bit of a run here.
Just before all this kerfuffle, it looked like Alex Davison was starting to have balance problems with that car as well. So we'll keep an eye on him, the blue car, the Gelbourne entry 18. He's currently there in fourth.
Now, Winterbottom was very strong before the safety car. He's got a good run out of Southern Loop. On board there with Jamie Wincup, looking back at Van Gisbergen. Oh, that's big.
That was pyre.
That'll make contact with another car down there.
You want? And it did. It's made contact with quite a few. Huge damage. James Courtney's involved. David Reynolds also went off. And the Fujitsu Commodore is an absolute wreck.
That's the third race meeting in a row for car number 22. And that's substantial damage on the GRM entry. So I saw a glimpse of, I think it was pyre in the background on the grass through the fast left-hander.
Gee.
At turn three. So that's
Alex Primer.
And James is okay.
James, he's been squashed.
Have a look at the steering column.
Oh. And Alex has gone just to try and help him get out. He won't be getting out on the driver's side. He's going to have to somehow needle his way through there. So it's awful to see such impact. James is out. He will be breathing hard.
I still haven't heard a safety car call. I don't understand why there isn't a safety car.
Okay, safety car, boards and flags. Oh. Safety car, boards and flags. I've got the medical response at turn four. Just a whole safety car.
So race control now getting a view there of the scene of the accident. And you'd have to say that James is very lucky in some sense because that right-hand driver's side door was completely squashed. I haven't seen one that kind of impact for a while, and that's what could have happened with the Jamie Wincup, Will Davison incident.
It's Jason Bush and Alistair McVane looking on there. Two of the key guys in the HRT engineering group, and they know straight away, looking at that vision, see the damage to the door. So the side intrusion, it's always the issue, and this is the problem. This is what you saw.
Yeah,
and
I had the wrong car, so it was, in fact, Premier that was out there. It wasn't Pye. But, and then you said that'll create a contact because he's got so much pace, you can't pull up on the grass or the rocks, and it'll be Courtney that Alex has grabbed. So apologies to Scott and friends and family there. But look at this. So all locked up, but there's no way known you can stop it on the grass.
And just in the wrong spot at the wrong time. This was Wincup last year.
So Reynolds will get by. Now here comes James Courtney as the car lifts, the Fujitsu car lifts. Oh! Ouch. All four wheels of James Courtney's car off the road at point of impact on the driver's side with the rear of Alex Premer's car hitting him at full force.
It's Alistair, he knows. Concern. Check this out in real time.
actually picked Courtney's car up, actually lifted the right-hand side of it off the road.
That is as big in terms of side intrusion contact as we've ever seen. In fact, lucky with the new generation cars that you sit further across, and a lot of work's gone in the driver's side to reinforce the structural integrity of that. So let's hope James is okay. We saw him with the medical guys getting out. He was limping as he went away, but that was a very good sign for him to get out the passenger side. Let's hope that he's okay.
Of course, like everything in the V8 supercars, it happens in the blink of an eye, so James would have had no time at all to brace for that. He wouldn't have known it was going to come. By the time he realised, car 34 was literally coming through high-siding on the driver's side door, and James takes a seat in the back of the medical car, Larko.
Thanks, Matthew. Just down here with Alistair. Did you get to quickly chat to James before he got out of the car at all, mate?
No, we didn't. The car looks like it shut off in the crash, so there's no radio, but so we don't know how he is.
Okay.
He's not happy.
What is great though when you look there is the side impact protection that the car offered really was at the fore there, wasn't it, mate?
It seems to have done a good job. You know, I don't think you can get a worse hit than that at that speed and at that angle. So he's got out, so that's a good start. Hopefully he's all okay.
Yeah, let's just hope he's had the wind knocked out of him. Thanks, Alistair.
Thank you.
Hey, Gary Rogers, good news. Alex looks all right, but that was a major hit.
It was, but I'd say obviously they're both okay. Clearly, Courtney looks winded from what I could see. Mind you, I'm no medical practitioner. I'm sure they'll have a look at him and make sure he is okay.
All right, thanks, Gary.
Yeah, okay.
So they're getting ready for a restart. It continues a horrible run of luck for James Courtney in particular. DNF at Bathurst, two DNFs at the Gold Coast. Again here,
Brown's had a big moment when he gassed up there and it slid. And he's got Witterbottom right behind him. He's going to stalk him.
This is a really difficult part of the race for these guys. They've had to restart.
Yeah, and Winterbottom must have got a spot when we were looking elsewhere because he looks racy now, doesn't he? I didn't spot that.
And they've only got one lap to do, remember, because it's 14 and then it's half-time in the 60-60. So what do you do here? You try and attack and get your spot. It's that risk management that we've been talking about. So this is your order. Craig Lowndes from Mark Winterbottom, Garth Tander, Alex Davison. Doing a good job holding position in the Geldwin Ford. Fabian Coulthard, Shane Van Gisbergen, Jamie Wincup. Our reigning series champ is seventh. This is where the Prema Courtney crash happened. Lee Holdsworth, Tim Blanchard, and Chaz Mostert make up our 10. Imagine that so much could go on in just the space of 14 laps.
We just got to consider how fast the place is, Matt. There you go, there's Van Gisbergen trying to get down the inside of Coulthard. Smart by Wincup.
He's going
to pull back. I just don't want to know about this. But he's got to run. He's got to run.
And he's tapping at him at the moment. He'll get under him here with that sort of pace. He's going to be a real pest here down the inside. And he's actually grabbed a spot there. Locked together. They'll go off the road. They're off the road. Lowndes is in the weeds. Now he'll get looked at carefully for that Winterbottom. And that is the flag. Tander is the winner of the race. Alex Davison second from Fabian Coulthard. And that will cause an eruption in pit lane.
And that's what I was talking about. That was only for half time. How do they manage the risk?
So this is exactly right. So Tander, because this is the first half of the race, he's won this battle to get to the next piece. So he will start the next piece in the lead. But Lowndes back in 14th.
And Winterbottom back in fifth.
Yeah.
So Craig Lowndes was literally one turn away from starting the next leg of this race, this critical race, the fifth last race of the season, on the front row of the grid. Now he is way back in 15th. Jamie Wincup is up in sixth. So let's run you through these provisional results at the halftime part. Tander and Alex Davison. So remember, how they finish here is how they'll start the next 14 laps. So at the end of it, Mark Winterbottom and Jamie Wincup end up with the advantage over Craig Lowndes, with Will Davison also further back. he'll appear on our next page back in 21st. There he is at the top of that list. David Reynolds, Scott McLaughlin, James Courtney, Alex Premer, James Moffat, all suffering dramas. But wow! Can you believe this? So let's watch it. It starts back here.
And that's the crisscross. We saw Dave Reynolds do exactly the same thing to Wing Cup. There'll be steering damage on both cars with this, Matt.
And that's the moment that Winterbottom and Lowndes come together too hard. Lowndes goes spearing off. They all go flying past. Incredible.
So Lowndes ends up crossing the line in the 15th position. Not sure that I want to venture into the pit lane at the moment. Might just stay away from there for a minute or two. Here it is again from the other angle. So the problem is when you drive down the inside there and you tighten up the corner and you're trying to stay into it, you get a slide. So he slid straight into him and then I reckon has bent the steering and then the two of them are gone.
So this is the crisscross piece. There's a little bump in all that, which is sort of fine. This is the bit now. He's actually up far enough, but because the corner's tighter.
He's had a moment.
Yeah.
High drama here at the Sergeant Security Phillip Island 360. And there will be temperatures at boiling point up and down pit lane. That's where we're headed right after this break. You'll get the reaction first. Stay with us.
So who's happy and who's not? You just heard there from the Red Bull team, steering right hand down from that contact with Mark Winterbottom. So Will Davison finished 21st in that race. He'll be fired up from the contact with Van Gisbergen. Winterbottom crossed the line fourth. Remember, we're at halftime. No points awarded. Just gets you to the second half of the game. Wing Cup crossed the line seventh. Lowndes 15th. And Tanner's laughing at them all. Went past them all. So he will be the leader when we resume. Remember, it's the double file restart in the acceleration zone. Mark Winterbottom there with his Bathurst winning co-driver, Stephen Richards, who's lending support this weekend to the factory FPR team. I wonder if Craig Lowndes is going to go for a walk here and have a chat. Would be interesting to follow. But everyone's getting on and turning their cars around to get ready for the second half of this 60-60 super sprint format. Remember, 100 points on the line for the winner. No point in carrying on just yet because it's not over. This race is not done with. It's half time, just like a football match. Have a sit down, have a think about things. That is under investigation. Lowndes and Winterbottom, the contact at turn 11 on that final lap of the first half is under investigation in race control. So we've got post-race investigations to come from the Will Davison, Shane Van Gisbergen contact, and also the contact earlier between James Courtney and Jason Bright. Of course, Courtney and Alex Premer eliminated in a very nasty accident down at Honda Corner. Both drivers emerged from their cars, which are significantly damaged and indeed were left at the exit of Honda Corner for that last lap of the first half. Let's listen in here. Bit hard to hear because of all the rattle guns and the work going on. There's a smile on the face of Craig Lowndes, but you know that deep down inside there is a very hard racing driver there who will not be happy by seeing himself forced off the road. There's nothing he can do now but mount the fight back trail. So at halftime, it was Tander Davison, that's Alex Davison in the gel went forward. Coulthard third, he managed to pick up some spots too because of the last corner drama. Winterbottom, Van Gisbergen, Michael Caruso, the Norton Hornets Nissan started from 18th. He's sixth at halftime. Wing Cup is seventh. Holdsworth, Tim Blanchard, well done, in ninth. He and Chaz Mostert, his teammate, will line up alongside one another. This is what's left of Alex Premer's Commodore. He went off the road on the exit of turn three, just like Will Davison last year, and he smashed into the side of James Courtney's car, and both of those cars have been absolutely decimated, but they've done their job and protected their pilots. Courtney was turning through the right-hander when the Frenchman, who just simply couldn't stop, went firing into the side of the HRT car, and these new generation cars have held up really well in the case of side impact, which is always the one that is very, very difficult. Jamie Winkup conversing with his engineer, longtime engineer Mark Dutton there to the left. He's in a good position here to make up some points. Not every day that he qualifies 13th, but he's 7th for the restart, so he's made some ground. He's in the game, but there's still a bit of work to be done to get themselves ready for this second half. 14 laps down, and another 14 to come soon from the island. A Sergeant Security Phillip Island 360, the second last event of 2013, and we've been talking about this championship chase between the four drivers still left in the hunt. And can you believe that this would unfold on the last lap of the first half of this 60-60 race? You're riding with Craig Lowndes, championship leader, at this point the race leader, and in sight of the finish line, he ends up in the gravel in a controversial moment in the 2013 series. This will be investigated at the end of the race. So let's not forget, the race isn't declared until they get to lap 28. So nothing will change at this stage, depending on who you think's in the right or wrong. In fact, we're going to ask you that and let you have your say in our V8 viewer vote as you take a look. So watch this, the big contact right here as they come around turn 12. Whack. Off goes Lowndes. Steering damage to car 5, you'd think, as well. And Mark Winterbottom ends up in 4th. And Lowndes' hopes tumble right down to 15th.
Well, Matt, with the greatest respect, let's leave the fans aside for a minute. Let's ask Craig Lowndes what he felt about that, mate, because it goes back to the earlier corner, doesn't it? Let's just talk through your view of what happened there.
Look, there was there was contact coming out of MG. We were driving out of there and there was a little bit of a bump, and then he got the crisscross and got down inside of me, and I thought we'd be able to run two breaths through that last corner. But obviously, the track's been freshly surfaced, but not to be.
Craig, let me ask you, if you go back to where he had the initial, where he was in your rear quarter to make that crisscross, is that what allowed him to get up the inside in the first place?
Yes. I think that's, what it was. And, whether he had a better car at that point, it doesn't matter. Obviously, we've all go by the rules, the regulations about nose-to-tail contact. But the stewards will have a look at it and see what happens. Unfortunately, now we start now 15th and we've got to make our way back through the field.
Yeah, it's a tough one. So for clarity, it's not necessarily what the big incident was. It's maybe back a little earlier that the real issue is.
Well, I think that the corner before has set it up, and that's where whether they look at it, I don't know. Look, they're going to investigate it after the race, but as I said, we've got 15 cars now to beat.
Well, let's see if Barrett can add to this at your end, mate.
All right, just with Mark Winterbottom now, Larko. And Frosty, give us your take on that contact with Craig Lowndes. What happened?
You're racing hard out there and trying to go for this championship, and I was on the inside for that last corner, and he just kept turning, and we locked wheels, and he ended up off the track, so... There's first part of the 60-60, you don't want damage, but at the same time, I'm not going to let him win. So to win this championship, you're going to fight. If you're going to turn in, I'm going to get on the gas, and two of us are not going to finish in a good position. So we can't race each other too much. We've got to obviously focus on the big picture, but from the inside and the guy on the outside turns in, you're not going to back off. So that's what happened.
Thanks, Frosty.
Thanks, mate. Cheers.
Okay, so the drivers have had their say, playing it sort of a little bit straight down the line. What do you think at home? Go to our V8 Supercars website or use the 7 Sport app and let us know. Who was at fault? Was it Craig Lowndes? Was it Mark Winterbottom? Perhaps was it just one of those racing incidents? Either way, it will have a dramatic impact on the championship of 2013. After the break, Mark Scaife and Neil Crompton will have all the other information from Pit Lane. They're currently scouring it for news, and we'll give you an update as well on the situation of James Courtney. Stay with us.
So the recovery for these crashed cars is being undertaken at the moment, and they're very crashed cars. This is the work on Mark Winterbottom's car from the contact with Craig Lowndes, making sure that the steering and the suspension is okay and that they haven't overlooked anything that may have been damaged. It wasn't a massive hit, but it's enough. You can see there James Small to the left, the race engineer on car 5. So at the end of the first half, there were 25 cars on the lead lap. James Moffat had completed 6, but remember, he'd been in the lane, so if he can rejoin, he'll start down the back, but he will still be those laps down. And remember David Reynolds, he had a puncture, he rejoined 24th. Scott McLaughlin, he had a puncture, he rejoined 25th, so he'll start down the back for this second half as Alex Premer's car is taken away. You can see the way that those
panels on the modern day V8 supercar are essentially a little NASCAR like in terms of the way that they're clipped on there, rather than being like they were back in the day, of course, composite panels, and they're pretty strong stuff. And you can see that cage design, all these chassis were constructed by Pace Innovations on the Gold Coast in various forms. Some of the teams put them together themselves. Others took full delivery of a completed chassis and built the rest. But look at that. That is the driver's side. James Courtney could not get out of that door, and he got out through the passenger side with some assistance from Alex Premer. Look at the side panel there. That's a side intrusion panel. Have a look at it. Smashed. Look at the contact. He's a very lucky boy, James Courtney. Of course, with these cars, they're purpose-built race cars. They're not converted road cars, and that's critical because you can see where he's sitting is closer in to the center of the car than the side of the door, and that's critical in the case of a side impact. They've got to haul this thing, virtually drag it back up onto the tilt tray truck. Alistair Walker there from V8 Supercars in the race suit looks after all the recovery of the cars. And remember that we're still in halftime. We're just under 6 minutes to go before another 14 laps of racing. And let's just think about this for a moment. Garth Tander could very well get another race win, because this year it's been a bit of a drought for Big GT. Had a win in Townsville, but that is indeed his only win. Just four podiums for the former series champion. But he'll be the only man flying the flag for the Holden Racing team when this restarts, because this is the second car from the Walkinshaw Racing Run HRT squad, and it's busted. And you see there the AZ sign. That's the acceleration zone when Garth Tander will lead the field back under the double file restart and stand on the throttle. We'll run the AZ, depending on where you're from, zone next year. That'll be full-time for every restart in the championship after safety cars and the like. So it'll take away the grey area of who went, who didn't go, and who got the call before race control and the like. So in half-time at the Island, 14 down, 14 to come, and Garth Tander will lead us away when we get started.
Welcome back. Half-time here at the 60-60 Super Sprint. We asked you the question, who do you reckon was at fault there between Lowndes and Winterbottom on the final lap? Currently, Mark Winterbottom is a wanted man in the V8 supercar world. That incident is under investigation post-race. So we've still got 14 more laps, and this is the damage, the incredible damage, the likes of which we haven't seen for a long, long time in V8 supercars, of James Courtney's car. That's where the rear of Alex Premer's car came and whacked into it quite high as well. And look at that. That's looking towards where James Courtney was sitting. That whole right driver's side door has come across. The roll cage has also been bent. James couldn't get out from that side, obviously, so Alex had to help him and drag him out on the other side. He has gone to the medical center. He's been looked after by the medics here at the circuit. We'll bring you an update as soon as we got it, boys.
Plenty going on down here, as you said, Matty, and I think the whole thing's under investigation at the end of it. They're going to be here until midnight sorting it out. I went and spoke to Rob Starr, who looks after James Courtney, car number 22, used to work with Mark. The concern is around his leg. Didn't actually ask which one, but I'm assuming the right leg. He's otherwise fine, but the car's in a real mess, and they're just gutted down there because, as we said before, it's the third time in a row for them. Big, big damage with that car. His teammate, Garth Tander, who led them across the line at the conclusion of the first half of it, a lot of rear locking. They're making changes to that car. Quickly, the other things, Alex Davis and Dave Patterson spoke to them. It was massive oversteer. Big changes to that car, number 18, Scafie. David Reynolds... That tyre just went flat through turn one, no apparent reason. Of course, he was involved in subsequent drama as well. He hasn't got a reason for it, so that's a little bit of a concern. So maybe it's geometry or junk on the road. Will Davison, as a result of the problem he had with Shane Van Gisbergen up through MG, big vibration with that car now, so they're not quite sure what that is, and they're inspecting it as I left it to rush back down here. Bent steering on Winterbottom's car, which they're trying to do the best they can to rectify, and Jason Bright's now using the back half of this as a test, and they're changing the rear dampers in that car. What'd you find out?
Well, I've never seen so much drama, honestly. We know the championship's, you know, in the balance, but the amount of damage and the drama that unfolded in the last five laps of that has created plenty of friction in pit lane. Everybody is blowing about Van Gisbergen. Everybody is blowing about the bump and run tactics. So I haven't seen Craig Lowndes. That big smile, it's gone. He's got a very determined look on his face. He couldn't believe the contact that Winterbottom put on him at turn 11 to get down the inside. So there's a lot of friction there. His car, bent steering, as you said, They did a really good job. I watched them wheel align it. They've got it in the air and they wheel align that car to straighten it up. So if you think about the championship leader and the drama that's just unfolded, I haven't seen a reaction like that from a normally smiley Craig Lowndes for a long, long time.
Yeah, I tried to duck in and out as many garages as possible, and there's a lot of anger there at the moment because there's obviously a lot of cost attached to this whole thing as well, plus all the championship implications. So, look, this now sets up a pretty thrilling second half of this 60-60 Super Sprint. Don't forget, they've got to do a couple of races tomorrow. That seems like about a month away at the moment for these guys, but I can promise you there'll be more to all this later in the day, Matt, and we'll probably have to clean it up tomorrow morning.
Yeah, it's all about survival, I reckon, boys, for the next 14 laps. By the way, James Moffat will take no further part in the race this afternoon. Car 360 out. We're being told that James Courtney just has soft tissue damage, no broken bones. He's a very lucky boy after one of the biggest accidents we've seen in the V8 supercar. So the second half of the 60-60 Super Sprint is coming your way here at the Sergeant Security Phillip Island 360.
And again, just massive damage to both of these cars. And remember, the James Courtney car has been crashed a few times by Greg Murphy at Bathurst. And then again, he was tipped into a spin on the Gold Coast. So another repair job on that car. And the steering let go when Courtney was running up front on the Gold Coast. So that's four races in a row that he's failed to finish. And remember, he was on the fringes of being a title contender before the Enduros. But that is well and truly out the door. And now for this man, Craig Lowndes, he must fight back. He must salvage from this race. He's 15th for the restart. Wincup, his teammate, is 7th. Winterbottom is 4th. And the man who's 4th in the championship picture is way back. Will Davison, 21st. So let's see. Clearly Shane Van Gisbergen has been riling a few of them up. He's been tapping bumpers and getting involved in all sorts of racing. Remember, he and Chaz Mostert were side by side on the run through Hayes Shed, and there was contact that sent Mostert off the road. Very high speed. Pit exit is open and cars rejoining. Jonathan Webb first out. He will restart 20th and fresh back from a trip to the US. Lots of drivers actually have been away on little trips in between the Gold Coast and Phillip Island. Tim Slay, James Moffat, Jack Perkins, a range of them went to the United States, checked out a NASCAR race and caught up with fellow Aussie Marcus Ambrose. Mauro Engel was at Macau driving for Erebus in one of their SLS GT cars at the famous Macau Grand Prix. So not quite the end of the season and still some trips going on, but now we're back down to business. Cars moving back onto the track for this second half of the 60-60 Super Sprint. It'll be a double file restart. Garth Tander will be the man who controls it into the acceleration zone. And here's Craig Lowndes, position 15. Set a 132.8 in the first half. In fact, he was the only man in the 132s. So he's broken his own lap record from here last year. We were here in May 2012, so it's been 18 months since we were here with the championship. But of course, new generation cars, resurfaced racetrack. So very different conditions. But look at that, still gravel there on the inside of Honda Corner, so we might need to get that swept away as well. Great stuff from Lee Holdsworth. Eighth in the Ewan Mercedes, just behind Lowndes on the road there. So the Erebus team keep moving forward. They're chipping away. Tim Slade was 14th. And Mauro Engel was 23rd. Still questions over, do they run three cars? Do they run two cars next year? Who sponsors them is another question, because it's been confirmed Irwin won't be there. SP Tools will be with the Holden Racing team. Still questions over James Rosenberg, who owns the racing entitlements contract of the 47 car. It's all about the business on the track right now. There's been drama aplenty in the first half. Let's see if we've got any more in the tank for this second half as the cars are on the road. Garth Tander will be the man to lead us away. Alex Davison on the front row, set to be a big second half of this 60-60 Super Sprint.
Drama. That's what we got out of the first half of today's 60-60 Super Sprint. On your V8 viewer vote, you're pointing the finger at Mark Winterbottom over that last turn incident on lap 14. It put Winterbottom in fourth. It means that Lowndes will restart in 15th. Garth Tander will be at the head of the queue. Thanks for having your say, and keep that 7 Sport app and V8 Supercars website open and ready to rumble, because there'll be more coming our way. We're keeping an eye on James Courtney. Barretts, what can you tell us?
Matt, he's currently in the medical centre here, and look, he was able to tell Dr. Carl Lee, the V8 Supercars doctor, that he did not black out during that incident. He was kept his consciousness all the way through. The thing, I guess, that was probably hardest for James Courtney was he just didn't see it coming. He said he had no time to brace. He has a lot of soft tissue damage. He's got muscle pain and that sort of thing. We can confirm that he has no broken bones, but they will keep him here for observation for around about half an hour just to make sure. And then he'll be sent for precautionary x-rays just to double check, as Dr. Carl likes to do. But the good news is for Karis Courtney and his family at home on the Gold Coast that James is going okay. He's fine and he's going to be okay in the next half hour or so. We hope to have a chat with James.
All right, mate, thank you. He's a fighter. We wish him well. He'll be up and about hopefully pretty soon. But that was just a crazy, crazy incident. I mean, we've seen big impacts. We've seen high speeders. We've seen weird ones come out of left field. But that one where the car actually hit James's driver's side door at height, pretty much head height, is just makes your head shake with wonder how we manage to protect our V8 supercar drivers like we do.
Safety car lights off.
I don't know what Craig...
So he's not happy about something.
Well, he certainly wasn't happy when I left him in pit lane.
I tell you what he wouldn't be happy about, where he's about to start.
Well,
in 15th. So they grid up, and remember, it's a double file rolling restart, so Garth Tander will have control of the field once they complete a couple of formation laps. But where is Garth?
He's coming through the field. He's actually sneaking it. There
Garth,
he is.
Where are you?
He's doing a little slalom.
Yeah, they were doing everything they could to make changes to that car, so that's probably what's held him up to get out. But you fellas were using the phrase a minute ago, not happy, and then adding to it. I think you just say there's a lot of blokes out there not happy, full stop. There's a lot of anger up and down that pit lane.
Well, it shapes up at the start of this, because there's a lot of the guys in that phase between winter bottom, Wing Cup and back to where Craig is, who have had a lot of drama. Chas Mostert, who was right up there in contention there, did a really good job early in the race. He got caught wide with Alex Davison. Davison actually held on pretty well.
Alex Davison could be in line here for his first ever V8 supercar race win. He's at the front row. He's got Garth Tander alongside him. He's got all these championship contenders slugging it out, throwing punches left, right and centre. We'll grab a quick break, bring you back to the island straight after this.
So the car's about to set off behind the Petters STP Chrysler safety car. So let's run you through who is where for this restart. We're down to 25. We've lost three. Moffat, Premer and Courtney will not take the restart for this second half. So it's Tander and Alex Davison 1-2. Coulthard and Winterbottom next. Van Gisbergen and the best Nissan, Michael Caruso next. Wing Cup 7th. Holdsworth, the best Erebus Mercedes, he's 8th. Blanchard and Mostert, teammates 9th and 10th. David Wall, quiet achiever, he's 11th from Russell Ingall. Then Delberto, Slade, Lowndes is 15th. Brothers Kelly in the Nissans, Rick ahead of Todd. Then Scott Pye, Jason Bright, Jonathan Webb, Will Davison 21st. Dean Fiore, Mauro Engel, David Reynolds had a puncture in the first half. He's down the back in 24th, as did Scotty McLaughlin. And he is positioned 25, so the cars roll away. They'll form up to double file a little later on in this roll-around lap. And we'll get this race restarted. Of course, if you've just joined us, this is the second half of race 32. It's not two separate races. It's the one race split into two halves. So championship points are on the line in this one. 100 points to the race winner. And as it sits here, Winterbottom stands to gain, but controversial clash with Craig Lowndes on the last corner of the last lap of the first half. That'll be dealt with later. There'll be a post-race investigation from Shane Van Gisbergen making contact and spinning Will Davison, and also from James Courtney getting into the side of Jason Bright right here at this corner, which eventually claimed Courtney when Premer's out of control Fujitsu Commodore on the grass plowed into the side of the 22 HRT VF Commodore. But both drivers emerged from their cars okay. James Courtney pretty sore. But we're getting set for this second half. This is bound to be good.
Okay, here we go again. the second half about to get underway. You look around this circuit, you think, wow, this place is so rugged, so dramatic and so unpredictable. And that sums up exactly what those 14 laps were. So the V8 supercars have blended perfectly into the surroundings here at Phillip Island. So remember, this is how it plays out. This will be the final 60-60 super sprint that we see. It's a double file rolling restart. The safety car will leave the circuit, leave Garth Tander in control of the race. There is an acceleration zone along the front straightaway that Garth can put the foot down at any time in between that zone. You'll see the orange AZ boards on the driver's right as they come up. So there's a little area there where Garth has the race in his control.
Matthew, I'd love to have a chat with Roland Dame, team principal down here at Red Bull. Mate, so Jamie's gone forward. That's all very good. Craig backwards. First of all, I want to get your read on that incident between Lowndes and Winterbottom.
Winterbottom was out of order, writing checks he couldn't cash at the last corner. He pushed Lowndes off at the last corner. They could have gone side by side down the front straight. And anyway, it's academic. There's no points for that part. It was one of the silliest moves I've ever seen. He would have been on the front row and he could have had a proper race.
All right, thank you for that, mate. And Jamie, good effort to move up forward, and he's going to go forward from here, I'm sure, again.
Yeah, well, it wasn't really good, though, because we didn't have car pace with him. So hopefully we made a tweak there and got a bit more pace for him.
And just quickly, I saw you put the string lines on Craig Lowndes' car. Was it bent?
Yeah, absolutely. Tracking was bent out in that contact at the last turn.
All right, thanks, Roland.
So that's going to be a handful for Lowndes to control.
Well, I know it was. It looked like it was about 15 mil out when I was looking at it. So they've done a very good job to be able to wheel align that car on the run. So those surrounding Craig Lowndes here, behind him Rick Kelly, Todd Kelly, in front of him you've got Tim Slade, Tony Delberto. So he's smack bang in the midfield, Craig Lowndes. That's going to be a big day out for him the remaining half of this race.
Aaron Noonan's just informed me they've changed a gear shifter in Tim Slade's car at half time, so that's a pretty quick turnaround.
The right-hand rear of David Reynolds' car. Yeah. Frank Adamson was looking at that very carefully. It looked like it had been bitten by one of the white pointers that lurks around off the end of Phillip Island down here. There's like the whole quarter of the car missing, but they patched it up.
Great shots there of three of the four guys in contention to win this championship. On your left, Winterbottom. Top right, Wincup. Bottom right, Lowndes. And this will be one of the restarts through the year that we've seen where the guys on the front row, the guy on the wrong side of the road, meaning Alex Davison, is a chance of still being in the lead of this race at the start. Because although Garth Tander will control the pace, it's far enough down to the first corner and a corner that you can get around there together. So this will be very interesting for turn two and then down to turn four.
But it'll only be useful for Alex if they've tidied the balance of that car, because it was a sprint car. It was a real handful in the back end of the first 14 laps.
So we've seen the 60-60 restart at Tasmania at Barbagello. It was awesome watching them come over the hill there at Darwin, Queensland Raceway in Winton.
Okay, the grid should be falling. Two by two.
So you push them wide. So what Davison does now is he runs him wide and runs him into the dirty track surface. You can see it on the outside.
Between 50 and the 60 kilometres now.
And watch Shane Van Gisbergen as well. Bit of chat about him at the moment.
It's up to you now, mate, on the green flag drop.
This is going to be fantastic. 25 cars in this field. Courtney Primer and Moffat not taking part. That may also play a part too in the back end of this race, the weather above us. So they crawl their way up Gardiner Straight. Mind games being played. Garth Tander is the ultimate pro. He's been around a long time. And he knows this circuit
green flag,
so well.
Green flag.
There's the acceleration zone. He can go anytime he wants from now, and they'll all have to go and follow him. Good restart from Garth Tander. He played it beautifully, but look at Alex Davison. The gel went forward, has a peak on the inside at turn one. Shane Van Gisbergen slots into fourth behind Fabian Coulthard. So Jamie Wincup gets through cleanly. Craig Lowndes, middle of the field. Wincup and Winterbottom are paired together now. Turn three, down to the hairpin. Solid stuff from Garth Tander as he goes in search of his second win of the season.
Blanchard's doing a ripper job here as well at the moment, Matt. He's eighth.
Important move there, Wincup on Winterbottom. Very good restart, got away with it.
There's Lowndes. So he's come up to 13th. Just like the first half when Lowndes pulled away from the field, Tander's doing that straight away on Alex Davison. Remember, Alex yet to win a race. The V8 Supercar Championship.
Wincup
on the inside of Van Gisbergen.
That becomes the long way round here, though.
It's a bold move and a big slide. Return serve there for Winterbottom. Back up the inside. And I think that Blanchard will get it done too. He does. Good move.
And Wincup bailed out of that. He knew that it could have ended just like it did with Craig Lowndes. So Wincup didn't want to pick any more fights.
Well, the problem is getting down the inside at 10, it's all fine and dandy, but it puts you on the outside at the second last corner at turn 11. So then once it cranked sideways, Jamie was in trouble.
It's four spots.
Yeah, it cost him a bunch.
It's taking the spot from Van Gisbergen and going back four spots. So it's...
He's having another go now on Blanchard. A little bit of hip and shoulder at turn two.
Boston's right behind.
Well, Roland Dane mentioned, and Jamie Wincup has been saying it since practice, it's been hard to find the speed in that car this weekend, so Jamie's going to have to use his muscle and use his guile, and he does it right there. All that experience to get car number one through and get it through cleanly and make sure that he sticks by Mark Winterbottom.
Mostert is working hard on the back of his teammate Blanchard here, the Wilson security entries. There they are, Dick Johnson Racing.
Blanchard gave that away a little easy then into turn four. So he probably should have batted on with that a little bit because it was an easy manoeuvre in the end. So now one position. Watch out for Winterbottom down the inside. This is a great move from the previous lap, but he learned from that. He knows that he's actually got to do it at the next corner. Niels points the right one. It's this one. Turn 11, got to get down the inside. Yeah, trying to replicate the move he did on Lowndes.
You don't want to be outside there because it's grey, it's dirty, there's no grip. The cars will immediately jump sideways and that'll kill your run onto the straight as well because you don't get through the final corner correctly.
There were harsh words in the first half between FPR and Shane Van Gisbergen with that coming together of Will Davison. These two have history as well at this circuit. So the Kiwi is the villain in this piece. As Mark Winterbottom and Jamie Wincup.
But just picture that, Matt. Mark Winterbottom almost dived down the inside, 285 kilometres an hour, turn it in, it's 210 kilometres an hour. You see Van Gisbergen out sideways. They are driving the cars as fast as you can possibly drive them. High level commitment at one of the best racetracks in our circus.
Lowndes has dropped a few spots too. Lowndes has gone back down to 16th. He came up to 13th, so he's had an issue in the last lap or so.
It's wounded,
yeah.
and he's in the pack. So it won't be steering well, and he's exactly where you do not want to be if you want to make lap speed. This is Coulthard, Lockwood Racing entry. He's working hard on the back of Alex Davison. So Dave Patterson, his new engineer, and Alex happened to come up with a quick fix to be able to get this car back in its performance window.
We've had five rookie winners this season. Fabian Coulthard was one of them. His breakthrough career win earlier in the season. Can Alex Davison join them today? Campbell Little moving on to Dick Johnson Racing to be their sporting director. So Dave Patterson comes in. Alex has already mentioned that he liked working with Campbell, loves him, but sometimes it's good to get a fresh outlook and it's paying dividends. So now Winterbottom.
Got it.
Gets past Van Gisbergen.
Good pass. Important pass, that one.
So that moves Mark Winterbottom up to fourth position. How's how tight that little group is there. And one of the things, one of the comments that echoed out of the pit lane from that previous half was a lot of bump and run. There was a lot of unsettling of the other guy that you were racing. Bump, 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 and then making a pass. And that'll be something that gets investigated carefully when they try and come up with determinations later on this evening.
As you said, Lowndes is parked. Lowndes just in front of Bright, behind Todd Kelly. It turned. This is on board now with Mark Winterbottom on the replay. Van Gisbergen made his own little mistake there. He didn't get bumped there. He made a little turn-in error, ran a little bit wide, got too sideways, and Winterbottom down the inside. A very good manoeuvre.
James Small watching on with Tim Edwards. James, of course, celebrating that Bathurst win with his charge. Mark Winterbottom and Stephen Richards. Stevie is here this weekend, pushing the Ford Performance Racing crew on. It's a battle at the front, though, between Tander and Davison as this championship chase continues to unfold.
And Tander has margin. This is what it looks like. 1.5 seconds back to Alex Davison, who hasn't had a podium since Abu Dhabi in 2011 when he drove for Stone Brothers Racing. Coulthard has had a top-notch year, his best season in V8 Supercars. He's on his hammer. Winterbottom's catching. He took 0.3 of a second away that time around, and Davison's vulnerable. Coulthard, a little bit of a nibble on the bumper bar. And Alex is trying to straight line it off Southern Loop to give himself some margin, just like that, for this run through Stoner Corner and then into what's really known generally as Honda Corner over the years. There's Winterbottom, Van Gisbergen, Wing Cup, Tim Blanchard doing a stunning job in seventh. Delberto trying to get a move on David Wall, that's for 10th. Caruso just up in front. He sits in 9th in the Norton Hornet. The Ultima going very nicely. Best of the Mercs is Lee Holdsworth. He's back in 13th, but Coulthard is looking quite menacing here. Oh, Dean Fiore having a shocker. Dodo Insurance Commodore off the road. He's down the tail of the field, 25th and last of the runners. Coulthard in the gap. Alex moves across and there's some contact here now. Coulthard tries to stay on the throttle and drive it around the outside, but Alex will get up the inside here. This is great stuff. Now, can you go two by two through here? Lowndes and Winterbottom couldn't do it. This time Fabian tucks it in because he wants to get a run onto the Gardner straight, but it was a little bit messy. And it lets Winterbottom close on in. He's ripping margin away from these guys. The podium is beckoning. Tander's cleared away. 2.7 seconds. The number two Commodore has got margin. 9 to go in race 32. Wing Cup doesn't look like he's got anything more to move forward. Winterbottom looks like he does. He could chip away a few more points here. Brad Jones to the right. Mate, team owner. Phil Key to the left. Engineer for car 14. Trevor Ashby in the background there, former V8 supercar driver and now a sponsor of this team and a great friend of the championship. But it is on. Look at this. Caruso under pressure from Wall and Delberto. Alex Davison's got them starting to rack up and stack behind in this really high speed Congo line. Here's Lowndes trying to get a move on Todd Kelly. This is for 15th. Every point is crucial for him to stay in the game. Jason Bright fighting back. Remember, he had a spin after contact with James Courtney in the first half. And the skies are still a little dark around Phillip Island. Two more races tomorrow, but this one is a long, long way from done. There's Will Davison. He's trying to fight back too and go around Jason Bright for 17th. He was on the inside there. This is Alex Davison, his big brother, who's just been able to withstand that little charge that Coulthard had. There's Tander, that's the margin. A 32.8 for Garth that time. Alex, 32.7. Coulthard, 32.6. Winterbottom, 32.7. So it's starting to even out now. But Tander is in control at the island. This could be a championship-changing day.
Now, sometimes here at Phillip Island, you just don't know where to look, because it's all going on. And Bradley Jones is a nervous man. He's currently got Fabian Coulthard on the podium in third. Alex Davison is trying to hold him off. Alex has finished second twice before in V8 supercar races, yet to have a win. And Garth Tander is 2.6 seconds clear. But in terms of the championship, Mark Winterbottom
is fourth, Jamie Wincup is sixth, and Craig Lowndes is 15th.
And that's what it looks like as they sit on the road at the moment. So remember, we came in with a plus 6 points for Craig Lowndes. It's now gone minus 22 for him. Wincup, as it sits at the moment, leads the championship again. All this to play out officially as the results roll in at the back end. And it's a net gain for Winterbottom as well, because he came in 88 odd points back. He's now 70 points behind the lead. He's in third, and of course Will Davison is still in fourth position. Provisional at this stage, but we wanted to give you an idea.
And also, Mark Winterbottom has the best speed at the back end of this race. Up to this point, he's set the lap record on lap 19. 132.42 is now the benchmark time around Phillip Island for the V8 Supercars. So the mission here for Alex Davison and the gel Gwen Ford is to stay on this podium. Look at them all lining up.
It definitely looks like they made an improvement with that car of Alex's, but he's got a big queue behind him. That's always a sign that he doesn't quite have the pace. But it doesn't look as diabolical as it did in the first 14 laps, where at the back end of that he was battling.
We've made mention of Alex throughout the course of the year. He's had his ups and downs. Back in full-time V8 supercar racing, but he's a fighter, Alex.
This is a very, very good job also, Tim Blanchard. Just want to make a point about that again in car number 17 there. Chas Mostert joined the championship at the Perth round and has done some great things this year. But young Tim's matching him out there at the moment. That's an impressive performance. They are 7th and 8th in those Wilson Security Dick Johnson Racing Fords. There they are, heading up to the top of Lukey Heights.
Mark Winterbottom, he's really got to try and organise this pass on Coulthard and Davison, because his speed is good enough. What you said before, Matt, on lap 19, he did the fastest lap of the race, got himself organised to there. But once you get in the slipstream here, it's very hard around the big fast. Got a big moment there for Coulthard. That was a big slide. That'll give Winterbottom the run. That was a very late slide. Oh! He's run into him. They've made contact into the main straight.
Whoa.
Had to have. He got a really good run on him. Fabian had a big slide and got a really good run, moved it over, and bang. So at 285 kilometres an hour, they've made contact. I was about to say, it's important because there's 12 points in it for him. If he gets by these two guys in front, he'll be 58 points behind the leader. 12 points, very important in this championship. I'm sure that was contact. That was so close.
Looked like it was heading that way.
So watch this. This is the big moment. Big slide. Runs wide. So then, got the run. Here we go. He should have gone left. He's moved over and bang, absolutely contact. That's as wild as you ever see.
And that's just over the crest too.
Yeah, just on the fifth to sixth gear change, Phil Keady's engineer. That's momentarily taking some pressure away from Alex Davison when we held our breath for Fabian and Mark Winterbottom on the main straight. So an extra couple of car lengths will be a welcome relief for Alex Davison at the moment when his mirrors are full of these cars.
Like you say, Crompo, when you see these conga lines forming, they're normally brewing up some sort of danger. So you can imagine how not only Mark Winterbottom, but that man, Jamie Wincup, is feeling right now. Shane Van Gisbergen's ahead of him. Tim Blanchard and Chas Mostert, who you've already documented with good pace, and another tyre's gone. Another one's gone. This is the heavy haulage Australia Mercedes-Benz of Tim Slade on the move to Walkinshaw in 2014.
Currently showing position 25, and that'll bring him back to the pit lane.
So Craig Lowndes has moved up. Got by, we saw there a little while ago, Todd Kelly. He was just with Bright. So he's up into 12th. So he's 16 points behind.
So 3 second margin exactly. Oh. Tander to Davison.
So Van Gisbergen's just dropped a bunch of spots here, Neil. And that's good news for Wincup. And for Tim Blanchard and Chas Mostert. But Wincup, who now leads the championship, if it finished like this, gets some more points. And gets closer to Mark Winterbottom, who's close to Fabian Coulthard, who continually tries to get around Alex Davison. Forget about Garth Tander, he's 3 seconds up the road.
He's had 5 third placings this year, Fabian Coulthard. He's on target to grab another, and if he does that, he actually joins Mark Winterbottom, who's racing him from behind, who's also had that number of third spot on the podium.
So Fabian's got a pretty good run here on Alex. 4 laps to go with this, and he's probably had better pace the whole time. It's a hard place to pass because you're going so fast, and the aero effect of the car behind is hard to stay right where he is now.
Good game there for Winterbottom through turn one as well. Brought him back good in run. Touch. So all three of them are tied together again now. So Coulthard's got a good exit off too. So has Frosty. Meantime, Van Gisbergen's gone back into position 8 after that little mistake that we captured. And they have a look at the inside at turn 4, but it very rarely gets done cleanly down there unless you've got a lot of space and you're given a lot of room.
Now, if I was Jamie Whincup, I'd park up. I'd basically say, you guys, you go your hardest. You blew about second, and I'll just cruise here for a minute.
If you get too greedy now, you potentially leap into DNF. Did not finish territory. I'm sure that's in his mind. Roland Dane uses the phrase, you need to know who you're racing. Well, at the moment, he's got a big battle going with Mark Winterbottom and the risk and reward. You've got to think very carefully about that.
So Lowndes moves up one more spot to 11th. So the move that Whincup has been able to move up slightly because of Van Gisbergen's mistake, it's now 20 points separating 1 and 2 in the 2013 championship, and a good run there by Winterbottom again. He's got the run. Oh!
He's getting the double benefit as well because two cars in front are producing a big hole in the air for him to get some gain. Remember that Windcup's on this train as well.
Stay back. Stay out of that.
That's his conscience speaking.
Yeah, that's right. Funny, Dad never said anything when he was racing.
I only recall that particular voice being attached to devil horns. I don't remember it being the angel saying, stay back.
So Alex Davison doing a wonderful job here. He was last on the podium in 2011 at Abu Dhabi when he finished second. He also finished second at Hidden Valley. And he's holding at bay Fabian Coulthard, Winterbottom and Whincup.
Fabian's blowing on the radio saying he's blocking. We'll see what the blocking tactic is here because this is one of the key spots. Remember the pace that Winterbottom has shown out of turn 11. So this is Lukey Heights over the hill, down into MG and down the inside. He gets it.
He's got it done.
This time will be enough. Good move. Now what he's got to do, he's got to turn back. He's got to get that move done. Winterbottom now will want to get up the inside of Davison in a similar manoeuvre to what he did with Lowndes.
That's a good job, Fabian Coulthard.
He's run wide. Wickham's got a good run.
2 to go. 3.9 seconds Tander to Davison. Nice move, Coulthard. Davison's under pressure. Frosty's all over him. Wincup's buying in. Blanchard's continuing to do an awesome job behind the reigning champion. See, Wincup cannot afford to blink here either.
No. His pace here, Frosty's pace off here is very good. He's got a bit better run than Alex. Alex ran wide right at the end of the corner. Might be a little bit of teams of Bright. He was running in 15th or 16th with another tyre failure on the right front. Alex blocks down there at turn 4. So Frosty needs to set him up. That was a good move by Coulthard. He did a really good job in the middle of Lukey Heights. I'll explain it to you in a second. So he come out of here, out of Siberia, around the left-hand kink, through the past hay shed. Massively fast, one of the fastest corners in our tour, 240 kilometres an hour, up to there, Lukey Heights, over the top of the hill, tyre debris on the road. Let's hope we get away with that. That's only back of turn 1. Now this is the spot where he's got to get a job done. He's got a wide entry and a narrow exit to try to get the best drive traction out of turn 11. He hasn't been able to do it. So Alex is holding on.
And they're going to come up towards that debris that we saw.
Middle of turn one.
It's strewn along the front straight. Reaction time is good enough for these guys to get through, and that's the big chunk right there, just on the outside of the racing line. So if you're coming in two abreast there, you're going to run into trouble. Appears as though Jamie Wincup is happy to take your advice here, Mark Scaife, and just stay out of trouble. He knows he's got the championship lead. It's been a terrific job from Garth Tander. When he watches this replay back, he'll know why that we've been focusing on these guys.
He got him. He got him. Wincup's down the inside, and he's actually made it stick. He was on the dirty side of the road, had the full wriggles up, but he's actually got it done. That was a great opportunistic move.
That's risk.
And that's a move that says, I'm in control of this championship right now. These guys have been playing mind games all year, Wincup and Winterbottom. They've come to blows on the racetrack as well all year. And boy, that could be a defining moment in the series race of 2013. Still a lot to play out as the two Wilson Security DJR Fords come side by side as Mostert and Blanchard wrestle for position number six. Congratulations and a great, typical professional job from Garth Tander to get his second race win of the season.
Great drive, job done.
And take out the 60-60 Super Sprint.
Awesome. Thank you very, very much.
Fabian Coulthard and Alex Davison on the podium. Oh, look at Craig Lowndes.
He got him. Lowndes got a spot then to eighth. He actually got past Mostert. He got him on the line.
And broke the lap record on the last lap. 32.38, new lap record, Craig Lowndes.
And the last 10 metres, two of those wheels were on the grass, I reckon.
That move by Wincup, 12 points. 12 points on Winterbottom. That's worth diving for. Wow.
So the Holden Racing Team have a celebration for car number two, Garth Tander. They'll have their thoughts, of course, on James Courtney, who's under the care of the medical crew here, Dr. Carl Lee. James is okay after that huge impact that ruled him out of the second half of this race. So, second race win of the year for Garth. His fifth at this circuit. And he made the most of what was in front of him to get win number 52 of his career. So, Fabian Coulthard, good pace at the back end. Now, watch this. Keep your eyes on the left-hand side of the screen as Garth Tander crosses the line. And Craig Lowndes will come into view. Here he comes and zips along the far right-hand side of the circuit. It's a game of inches.
Here we go, on board with Lowndes. So Van Gisbergen and Mostert are bumping. They have that little drama. Mostert gets wide, got the momentum, does a great job, flicks right, no road, gets it through. That is very, very good driving.
That was the Lightning McQueen with the tongue out at the line, wasn't it? That was
Have a look
close.
At the road. Have a look at how he had no road to work with.
Well, he didn't. He ran out of road. So he just took the option of, I'll take whatever's there. So he takes the white line. He takes some of the dirt with him. And he sets a lap record on the final lap of the race to make amends for that disaster at halftime.
33 ten-thousandths of a second. The Lowndes margin
to Mostert.
Unbelievable. That is great racing. Fabian Coulthard and Alex Davison did a very good job. And Garth was the recipient of their battle, wasn't he? They battled pretty much the whole race. Garth was able to sneak away. It was a very good drive.
Ended up plus 3 seconds at the end for Tander while they were all in an arm wrestle. So second win of the year for Garth Tander. Last one of those came at Townsville. This will be a moment of real joy for these guys, particularly for the difficult run in the other half of the garage.
Adrian Raskin. Shaking hands.
Hello.
Sebastian Tander, and of course Leanne's always there by his side. So a Holden 1-2. And a great way for Alex Davison and the Gerald Wendt Ford and Charlie Schwerkholt to finish this Saturday and get on the podium as well. Man, that was so dramatic.
Hey, Garth Tander, you set out to win this race and you did it beautifully. Congratulations.
Yeah, thanks, Brett. It was all the last corner of the last lap of the last race that set up the race win. So, yeah, we made a change to the car in the halftime break and the car was really good then. So once we got the gap, we're just managing the gap back to Alex and Fabs who are racing on, obviously. So, yeah, really happy with that. So helps our championship. Not sure what's going on with the other guys, but doesn't really concern us.
Well done, mate. Enjoy that podium. Great win. Fabian Coulthard, too, fantastic performance. Straight out of the car to congratulate Garth Tander as well. Fabian, congratulations to you. Great performance. And that was a tremendous move on Alex Davison there towards the end of the race.
Yeah, look, I tried it a few laps earlier, but the door closed. So, look, you got to keep it clean and fair, and, you know, that's what I'm about. But got a bit of a flu, but it's not all bad. You know, we're battling along. You know, we were pretty unhappy yesterday, but, you know, to drag a podium out of a car that we were really battling with. So a credit to the boys and obviously all our sponsors, Lockwood. You know, they've done a fantastic job.
How tough was that to find your way past Alex and to have Mark Winterbottom right on your heels as well?
Yeah, look, it's never easy, but, you know, sometimes you've got to make gaps. And I was getting a little bit impatient there for a while. But, yeah, look, I made a clean move and got past Alex and another podium for the boys.
Well done, Fab. Enjoy that. Good
Thanks.
Work.
Cheers.
And Alex Davison, boy, fantastic work as Alex enjoys third spot on the podium. Been here a couple of times this year, Alex. Well done, mate. That's a fantastic result for you. And under tough conditions too. They're all coming for you there at the end.
Oh, that was the toughest race I've ever done. The car wasn't as nice in the race as in qualifying. We tried to tune it up for that second leg, but it was so oversteery. So I was fighting tooth and nail to keep Fabian back. I thought I might be able to. I sort of got a couple of car lengths a couple of times, but... you know, he was too good on the day. And then I was hoping, you know, the other guys weren't going to be coming for me too. So hard work keeping those guys back. It was, I wasn't going to let that podium go easily, I can give you the tip. But wrapped for everyone at Geelwin, wrapped for Charlie, everyone at FPR, who's, we've had a bit of an up and down season. It's been a bit tough lately. So great to repay him with a podium. I'm wrapped. And great to get a podium with my wife, Melanie, and the kids here as well. It's awesome.
Great stuff, Alex. Jump up there and enjoy it. Well done.
Cheers.
Mark Winterbottom, sorry, mate, I had to take you away from the family. I know you well enough, I can read your body language. You're agitated. You clearly didn't like that move. Nothing wrong with the move, but Win Cup, it was a good move on you there towards the end.
Yeah, no, I'm not disappointed with that. Just probably the, you know, starting fifth and when probably should have been off pole, so probably more disappointed with that. And, you know, the car took a knock in that thing and you're just trying to survive out there then. So, yeah, it was a good move, but when you're behind your teammate as well, you can't go as deep as you can and all that sort of stuff, and I was surprised he made it stick. So yeah, did well, good job. It's 6 points, so do you crash again trying to hold on? Yeah, you've got these things going through your mind. So good race, it was all good.
Mate, hand on heart, this is world class. Standing back watching what you guys are doing out there, this is as good as it gets in the motor racing world. It's tough, I can see that, and nothing tougher than you and Lowndes out there in the first half of that segment there. Now, Roland Dane's comments about you weren't particularly nice. What's your read on that incident? We know it's under investigation. We don't know the outcome of this race yet.
Yeah, he always whinges and moans and, you know, he probably should be at the Ashes, not at the racetrack. But anyway, you know, he turned in on me and we had contact. You know, I thought we could have went side by side through the corner. I was far enough past. So, yeah, whatever, they sorted out. So if you start getting the nitty-gritty, you know, getting down to it, we'll hopefully win it on track, not in the stewards' box. So see what they say. But some of the standards this year and some of the stuff that their guys do, and then they nitpick their competitors, that's sometimes, you know, frustrating. So I won't get done. It was a fair move and, you know, probably he should get looked at more than me. So here's what it is.
Good on you, mate. Appreciate the heads up.
Thanks, buddy.
Yeah, and it's a good point too, Larko, and of course Frosty, that these results are provisional. We'll have a podium, we'll celebrate it, but there are quite a few inquiries to be held post-race. So Tander, Coulthard and Davison is our podium. Win Cup and winner bottom, that of course changes the scenario of the championship picture. We'll take a look at that just after the podium. Will Davison finishes in 17th, Rick Kelly there in 20th, and James Courtney, Alex Premer, James Moffat did not start the second half of that race. So 52 career wins now for Garth Tander. The Holden Racing team on the top step of the podium here at Phillip Island. Barretts.
Race 32 of our year, and it is the V8 Supercars Sergeant Security Phillip Island 360. Would you please congratulate our race winner in first place for the Holden Racing team, Garth Tander. In second place for Lockwood Racing, Fabian Coulthard. And in third place for Team Geldwen, Alex Davison. Representing the winning team, the Holden Racing team, Scott Sinclair. making the presentation of the third place trophy is Kevin Fitzsimmons, V8 Supercars Operations Manager, Dunlop. Presenting to second place is Paul Morris, the brand ambassador for Sergeant Security. And making the presentation to the winning team is Andrew Hutton, the commercial director, V8 Supercars. And finally, presenting the first place trophy is Peter Harris, the general manager of our naming rights sponsor, Sergeant Security. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2013 V8 Supercars Sergeant Security Phillip Island 360 race 32 winners.
I'll look back at this one and think, wow, how did we all get through that? It was only 28 laps, but boy, they squeezed quite a bit in. Garth Tenner has now won five races at this circuit. It's his first solo win here since 2007. But a dominant performance.